Arcanax login confirmed.
Welcome to the Lodge. You've accessed
the LodgeCast experience.
Warning, warning. Dangerous spoilers ahead. Enjoy.
The LodgeCast is a little podcast where we watch weird movies so you don't have to.
The LodgeCast, baby.
LodgeCast, gonna smoke this. LodgeCast, listen, movie pass. LodgeCast,
we're gonna watch some crap.
LodgeCast,
and then the Lodge Master chats
with Lucas
and Bishki.
Episode 106, F9, The Fast Saga. Hello and welcome to a fast, furious edition of the LodgeCast. I'm your LodgeMaster. With me as always is Brother Bishki in the front seat.
Vroom, vroom.
Lucas is the backseat driver today.
Catch me in the rear view 9 times.
9 times. Oh my God, guys. What the fuck are we doing today? We are at the Regal North Hollywood 4DX Theater.
In the new NoHo West Complex, where the old Robinson's May Mall used to exist at Laurel Canyon and Oxnard, in bright and sunny San Fernando Valley, North Hollywood, California.
We out here.
Lucas, we up in Lucas and I's hood. I come to this Trader Joe's in this complex.
I have definitely come to this Trader Joe's as well.
Yeah, it's a very nice one.
And because there is 4DX available, you better motherfucking believe we're going to F9 in 4DX, y'all.
Woo! And buckle up, because it's going to be a bumpy ride.
And it's brand new 4DX, so it's not going to be janky. It's going to be
clean, state-of-the-art, nice, just well-oiled.
Nice and tight.
It's going to be rocking and rolling and jabbing
now,
and jibbing.
Jibbing and jabbing. The last time I went to a 4DX experience was Dumbo with you.
Was with you, beautiful man. Yeah. Same, you same.
And then before that, it was the Meg with you boys.
Yep.
But before that, I believe it was Mad Max Fury Road. And coming away from that, I made one life rule. Never will I ever again go to 4DX for a movie that involves driving in any way, shape, or form. Because you're constantly being rocked and rolled. You're being jostled. You're being bumped. It was hellish, and that's a great movie.
Yeah.
Now, right. F9, I'm sure, is going to be an even better movie. But this movie is 2.5 hours
long.
Oh,
my God. Why did you tell me that?
Okay. No. Speaking of rules, no. Can I make one
run
rule?
Run out of gas at that length.
No matter how our stomachs feel, no matter if we got a headache, nothing. No,
you're
matter
running
what,
out empty with that runtime.
No matter what, no turning off the 4DX.
No turning it off.
Nope.
And no turning off the water feature either.
No, turning off anything.
Yeah, it's all got to be on. It's all got to be cranked.
And just so our LodgeCast listeners can visualize, I'm wearing my Jurassic Park pink polo employee tee because I want this experience to be on level with like Jurassic Park The Ride, sure. You know, Universal Studios.
Sure. Okay, so that's the technology of it. What's your guys' history with the Fast series? Now, I just assumed that you guys have both seen pretty much all of them, but that's not the fucking case?
No. I mean, the only connection I have to the franchise is in Chicago when I was in college, I saw Too Fast, Too Furious at the Logan Square Discount Run Theater for like $2 on a matinee because I lived around the corner and I was high probably. And the only reason I went to see it was because John Singleton, I believe, directed it. And I was like, this is my guy. He did The Boys in the Hood, but anyway, haven't seen any of them since.
Oh,
but
my
But I did hear from someone Fast 5 2011 is actually worth watching, but don't pay attention to the rest.
And it's all relative anyway. Bishki, what is your history?
Similar to LT, I watched Too Fast, Too Furious in like an
You guys have only seen Too Fast, Too Furious?
It was like an early digital projection before they should have been doing it.
Oh.
Like, Yeah, it was like really bad.
And that's it?
And then I think I caught the tail end of maybe Furious 7 or...
That doesn't count.
Or no, 6, I think.
Bishki, if you wouldn't mind, the naming conventions of these are abhorrent.
Yeah, yeah.
I know.
Can you run through the list of titles that lead us to where we're sitting today for F9?
Yeah. Fast Movies. Oh, here they are. The Fast and the Furious, 2001.
Yeah.
Too Fast, Too Furious, 2003.
Both numeral, Too Fast, Too Furious.
Mm-hmm. Numerals. The Fast and the Furious, : Tokyo Drift, 2006. Okay. Fast and Furious.
See, that's where it fucks up.
That's the fourth one?
2009.
That's
the fourth one, yeah.
And Furious.
It should have been Fast and number 4 Furious.
Fast 4 Furious? That's better somehow. That's better,
yeah.
Jesus, okay.
Fast 5, 2011.
Okay. But that's not a number. That's spelled 5,
that's
right?
That's spelled 5. Ugh. Fast and Furious 6. That's a number.
Wait, so Fast and Furious 6. Not the Fast and the Furious.
No, no. That's 2013. Jesus.
That's crazy. That's chaotic evil. That is just straight up chaotic evil.
It pisses me off.
Furious 7, drop the Fast. Furious 7, 2015. Then we get into The Fate of the Furious.
No.
Even I know that's bad. That's probably the weakest one in the franchise, and I haven't even seen
it's
it.
Long.
2017.
Oh.
Fast and Furious presents, Hobbs and Shaw.
No.
2019. No. And we get to the present day, F9.
Wow. I will say this. I remember in the before times, the three of us being at the Burbank 16 IMAX to see something.
Yeah.
And the F9 trailer teaser, the first teaser, not the new trailer they overplayed, right, but the first original teaser played.
Way back.
And brought down the house. It was so electric and euphoric and in such an eruption of enthusiasm that I wanted to see that movie instead of whatever it is we were seeing. I can't even remember what we wound up seeing. But I remember telling my friends.
You don't remember the movie. You remember the trailer.
Yeah, I remember telling my friends because one of them went to grad school with the writer of tonight's film, F9, Dan Casey. And I was like, tell Dan that the crowd just went wild. And
Boom,
like a couple months later, the pandemic hit. And here we are.
Something happens with these movies where I think I've seen all of these. By the way.
Wow.
Just did a spit take.
And I'm no super fan. I've just seen them all. Yeah. I'm a completist, I guess.
I mean, most people say this
too, yeah. Masochist, I mean.
But there's something that happens around Fast Five where they start getting so big. They keep adding more people. Like Helen Mirren is in this fucking movie. Hmm. Like it just keeps snowballing. And it's kind of a freak show. You want to go to just see how big a movie can get.
Yeah.
And
it's Looney Tunes.
The Lodge Mistress and I were at a film festival being held in a movie theater where we had a film showing. And instead of schmoozing with people and networking like we were supposed to do after our screening, we went straight to The Fate of the Furious. I was like, are we really doing this? Are we really leaving our own party to go to The Fate of the Furious? And we did, because she wanted to know too. She's like, it looks ridiculous.
Yeah.
So
redonkulous.
We are jumping right into the yak's mouth of insanity for 4DX. I don't know what we're in for.
I did a 9-minute YouTube video recap. I'm ready. Let's do this.
So you're an expert.
Yeah.
Wait, I'm sorry. There's one last thing I forgot to add. There was a riddle that I proposed to the Lodgecast boys today before we got here about 2 hours ago, where I said, will the hothead stay awake tonight for his 4DX screening as I have eaten 40 milligrams of watermelon, Starburst gummies to get in the right, mood to take this road trip. So here we go.
How could you fall asleep? You're going to be jostled for 2.5 hours. Yeah. Maybe you'll be just jostled to sleep like a little baby. Like it'll be rocking you to sleep.
I'm also inhaling my vape pen too to get that extra bump, It's like New Year's Eve for me. Let's go.
Let's do it. Love and light.
Oh, baby. Check me out. Take a look at yourself, analyze your life. But do you waste cheap money, cheat on your wife? Wake up with the night, go to bed with the sun. Is your main concern just to have fun? Forsake your family, forget your friends until the girls go home and the cash flow ends.
drink alcohol, corrode your brain. The body smoke a good reefer and sniff a cocaine. Does your life consist of material things? Fancy clothes, furs, and diamond rings. If any of these things apply to you, don't you think it's time you try something new? Grab hold of yourself and take the time to restore your body, relax your mind. Don't get caught up in a fantasy. You'll see how easy it can be living in the fast lane. Talk about it. Talking about it.
Oh my God, we're back. We're back from getting jostled.
Brain dead.
Oh, oh.
I want to see this movie in my rear view.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh, before we get into it.
Bishy, what's that shot?
From Rotten Tomatoes, Vin Diesel's Dom Toretto is leading a quiet life off the grid with Letty and his son, little Brian.
Good luck with that, Dom.
But they know that danger always lurks just over their peaceful horizon. This time, that threat will force Dom to confront the sins of his past if he's going to save those he loves most. His crew joins together to stop a world-shattering plot led by the most skilled assassin and high-performance driver they've ever encountered, a man who also happens to be Dom's forsaken brother, Jacob. John Cena.
John Cena.
The upcoming The Suicide Squad. Little plug there. Period. That's what it said.
That's it. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, man.
I'd like to point out that F9 was seen in the Theater 9.
Yes.
And we were in row G, and I was in seat G9, so the seat directly in front of me was
F9. Amazing. You point that out, and I'm like, either that's a great sign or an ominous sign. We'll see.
Yeah.
This is a brand new 4DX theater, which is cool.
Brand new. Still got that new car smell.
Smelled great. And we sat down, and they do the little trailer that shows off the 4DX experience. So you'll have the flashing lights and the moving seats and the punching you in the back. And people were not ready. Like, I wasn't ready.
No, same.
It just grabbed us and shook us like a dog with the toy that it's most angry at. And I was in despair. I was like, Bishki, 2.5 hours? No. Oh, my this fucking
was,
God.
That was way more than the downtown 4DX.
They hit you hard with the promo, the 4DX promo, because they want to sell everything. And they were hitting you so hard that when the strobe light up in the ceiling would go off, it was so bright that it would blow out the projector.
Yes.
Image, so the screen would get washed out. Yes. Like your parents turning your bedroom light on when you're watching a movie. It was not great. It definitely gave us all a giggle.
But then it settles down a little bit when the movie starts, because the movie is all peaks and valleys. It's either huge action set pieces or just flatline sub soap opera dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
And when that's going on, thankfully the seats give you a rest.
Yeah.
Because if it rumbled every time Vin Diesel made his like listless sphincter mouth face, I would be puking all over the place right now.
One thing I would have liked, and one of the elements of the 4DX is there's two like things that punch you in the back a little bit.
Yeah.
But that kind of felt nice.
Yeah.
If those gently punched you in the back during the dialogue scenes.
Yes.
To give you a nice little massage.
Massage you.
And then. And
why
then,
not?
Yeah.
They have the technology.
Yeah. It's clearly a massage chair.
Apparatus.
We're almost there. We almost have cracked the code.
But we didn't get that. We get the big standard Fast and Furious, but new to you guys, set pieces. They're all like this.
Yeah.
This is what every, especially latter day Fast and Furious movie is like, when they have more characters than lines of dialogue in the movie.
Mm-hmm.
And
characters that I have no idea who they are dramatically. So when they show up like at the end, like post credit teaser sting,
it doesn't matter.
I'm like, whatever. Like, don't know.
This movie is inherently dumb. No one from the top down would ever argue that it's not dumb.
No, they're trying.
That's what they're made for. But the whole joy of having like 9 movies in your franchise is that you need to have fun with it by this point, you know?
Yeah.
And they have all the toys in the universe. They have the biggest budget in the galaxy to do whatever they want with, but they can't go through and do a punch-up pass on, like, some of the one-liners. There are, like, no one-liners in this.
There's no salad dragon either.
Mm.
Well, there's a salad 4DX moment, but that was just the shock of the communal experience.
Oh, right. We'll get to that. I think I know what it
is. We'll get to that. But my point is, it's like, it's not as fun as it could be. You need to tune up the shit that would make, like, people were ready to laugh.
Yeah. 2.5 hours, too. You need to learn how to pace your movie. Because
pummeling, literally.
I had to get up and use the restroom because I drank a small Pepsi, which is kind of large, actually. and it shakes you loose. But I mean, I just felt like there were moments where we should have been cheering at certain endings to, like, sequences or set pieces, but there was no cheering. It was pretty much like a mute experience.
Like a car will blow up and then it'll zoom in on, like, Vin Diesel and he's supposed to say, like, yeah, nicely toasted or something like that. And he just kind of, like, sighs and then the scene's over. Like, what is that?
Yeah.
You're in your 9th movie. He should be Bugs fucking Bunny by now.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not that angry. Fast and the Furious.
It's because you're new here.
I'm new here. So it's like all the, you know, you want to be bigger and better. This is brand new to me. Yeah. I mean,
the cast used to at least be awake. They are so tired and depressed through most of at least the first half of this movie.
No, I would say like the whole movie, because Ludacris, who I haven't checked in with in a long time, he was kind of playing it. Like, every scene, he looked like he just gotten the worst news from his doctor. Like, you have cancer, and let me tell you why it's inoperable.
Yes.
And he just has this look on his face like, I have cancer. Yes. Like, they can't operate on
What's up with that?
Yeah, he looked really freaked.
It's like, okay, I get that it's the 9th movie, and I will end up cutting it some slack. But it's like people go to Rolling Stones concerts, and the Rolling Stones have done thousands upon thousands of concerts. But Mick Jagger isn't sitting there in a rocking chair looking depressed.
Yeah.
He's strutting around. Like, why aren't these people strutting around? They're getting paid up the ass to be in this stupid movie, and they'll probably be in 9 more. Why do they look like they want to die?
Yeah, I was really only perked up and engaged with the, I think it was the Tokyo Drift cast with Lucas Black and his counterparts, and they were funny and charming.
Lil Bow Wow's in this?
Yeah, and I was like, I kind of wish we were hanging out with these guys more.
Bishki, what do you think about those guys, Bow Wow and the crew?
Was that the crew at the jet propulsion?
Yes.
Yeah, they were fun.
And we flash back a lot. The Universal logo was a retro one where we all looked at each other like,
oh man,
are they going to screen The Fast and the Furious?
The 2001 on 35mm? We all got a little spooked.
But it was because there's a flashback from 1989 where you see young Dom and young John Cena. And
which I thought was a weird way to open it, because I don't know about you guys, but I just thought this is how Paul Walker died. Like,
also true.
His Porsche burst into flames, and the cold open is a race car like bursting into flames and like spinning out uncontrollably, like because it was going too fast. And I was like, this cannot be an unconscious choice.
Well, you deal with cars, you deal with car crashes.
I did like the subdued 4DX when he was burning in his car.
Yeah. Sometimes it's a real subtle, classy float that they give you on your chair. But I thought that the young Vin Diesel was far more compelling than Vin Diesel Prime.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he looked like something was actually going on behind the eyes. Vin Diesel is checked out. He's checked out. They'll just cut to him. I won't even give him the credit of saying he has a 1,000-yard stare. It's like a 1,000-inch stare to nothing. And his mouth, like I said, it's like sphincter pursed the whole time. Like, what are you doing, dude? Anyway, it's the 9th movie.
Yeah.
I get that you're new here, Bishki. I get that you're new here, Lucas. But, God, they need to pep it up.
No, I mean, at the beginning, that first sequence, I think we were in Mexico. My stomach was not handling it too well. I mean, it's kind of like roller coasters. I love roller coasters, but if it does too many loop-de-loops, my stomach starts to get the nauseous.
Yes.
And then the next one. So I was starting to fear the action sequences.
Yes. You dread.
Because you, know how bad it's going to pummel you. But eventually my stomach settled down.
But your brain gets pummeled by the dialogue sequences.
Yeah, your brain is completely checked out. I mean, by the by the last half hour, you're just brain...
You are brain dead.
I'm brain dead. I can't... I'm having trouble, like...
We got so much dumber at this movie. Oh, God. Like...
But
I stayed awake though.
Yes,
I
mean, couldn't have possibly
there's
slept.
There's no way you're falling asleep with wind blowing in your hair. And yeah, the guy next to me had his strobe on for his alerts. So whenever you got like a text,
I saw that.
There were other strobes out of my peripheral where I was like, man, this is 4DX everywhere.
I did hear a guy snoring behind us during a particularly long dialogue scene. Like Charlize Theron's in this like Hannibal Lecter box for pretty much the whole movie.
They shot her scenes in a weekend, by the way, like in 2 days.
And this dude was snoring, and then sure enough she gets out of there and gets in a stealth jet and starts bombing Vin Diesel's Dodge Charger, and he woke the fuck up. He was up. The technology worked. But I've been in basically a head-on collision before in my car in real life. Thankfully, it was a slow speed collision, but I was driving a yellow Mustang, so I
very furious.
Felt pretty furious, but that jostled me way less than this movie. Like even this movie's most gentle floating scene jostled me more than that head-on collision. I don't know how these people who just watched this movie aren't submitting insurance claims.
I thought someone was going to get injured after that first. You know, because we're the test subjects. This is a brand new 40X.
They might have it up to
high. Yeah, the one thing that you really want to think about if you're going to do this experience is you got to get to your seats on time. Because when the seats started moving and the like trailers or promo, there were people showing up late in the dark and with seats violently shaking.
You
got
to jump on like a bucking Bronco to sit down.
You can't even read the numbers. You have to ask good Samaritans to guide you. Like they know what they're doing.
Oh, and people were late. People were late to this movie.
Dozens, yeah.
They missed the whole intro flashback, and they were like mid-Mexico super action scene.
I will say this. This 4DX experience was a little smoother than the DTLA OG version, because when I saw Warcraft there in like 2000 whatever, like that hurt. I remember getting like bruised and injured, and I was like, I can't do this anymore. But here it was like a little more, like the only thing that hurt is my elbows would sometimes rub against the armrests.
Yeah,
so you kind of had to hold your arms up, otherwise they would get chafed, you know, in the seat. Mm-hmm.
I feel like my brain has hit my skull a few times.
You're definitely suffering mild concussions,
neck,
for sure.
Yeah, my neck, because I whiplashed a few times into the back of my seat.
Like, it was fucked up.
We talked towards the end, like the space stuff.
Space stuff I thought was great.
Yeah, the crowd. I thought the crowd got into it in the final action sequence.
Tyrese and Ludacris end up launching into orbit, and it's pretty funny. And the score shifts into kind of like spacey music when they're up there, which is pretty funny too.
Yeah, and every time they cut back, it's a laugh. And I kind of like the magnet stuff.
There's a lot of magnets. A
lot of magnet stuff, but I think that added to what would otherwise be just a kind of generic chase through the city scene.
Yep.
There was also a great audience reaction moment when John Cena got all pouty and was like, "You don't know anything about Dad." Oh. And the audience was like,
"John Cena,"
inappropriately laughing at him having like some juvenile adolescent moment.
I mean, he looks right, but his he's not an actor.
He's not an actor.
A lot of these people aren't actors. But we should talk about the the liquid salad dragon.
The Salad Dragon.
A scene in a movie that is so bizarre, baffling, or transcendent that it instantly justifies the price of admission. Or Reese Witherspoon's leafy transformation in A Wrinkle in Time.
So this is, for such a crazy movie, this is such a subtle, faint thing to bring up, but...
This moved us. This moved all of us.
It moved us. There's a flashback where a character you thought was dead is talking about how he didn't actually die, and a rainstorm starts, and this character walks out into the rain, and then suddenly, everybody in the theater gets a little jizz spritz of water in their face, and...
A little raindrop.
Strangers were turning to each other like, with such wonder.
Yeah.
It really
gave you like instant magic.
It was
like
magic.
Empathy. Yeah. I remember feeling like, oh, wow, this is really cool. Like,
but it was just one little spritz.
Yeah. Just to bring us to the scene.
Was it from the water spritz?
I think.
Yeah.
I thought it was from the ceiling.
I think there's an arc. I think Patui spits it up.
Yeah.
And it arcs and hits you on the top of the head.
Yeah. I hope we don't get Legionnaire's disease.
That's what I'm always wondering. Because there is a button that says water on, water off.
Oh, we were water on all the way.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
But who knows? Who knows if it was even water, guys? If it was like Brondo or like, something.
What do they run through those lines to clean them out?
It could be anything. It could be toilet water. It could be anything.
And I had to, by the way, for the whole movie, I had to hold my cell phone in my lap.
Because yes.
it would get shook loose in my pocket.
Oh, me too. Yeah. I thought it dropped to the depths. I was like, oh, yep, fuck.
I had it in my hand.
Yeah.
Can't be losing your cell phone down in the depths of the 4DX machinery.
That shit will break. It will not survive a fall in that environment.
Oh, my God. I mean, I don't know what's going to bring me back to the 4DX, but I'm good.
It'll be Avatar 3
I'm
or
good
2.
For a bit. If it's Avatar it's Avatar 2 through 4, I'm fine with that. Mm. But, oh, my God.
Or no. You know what? It'll be Top Gun Maverick for sure. Top Gun Maverick.
Sometimes, like...
No. It'll be Top Gun Maverick. We're doing it. And we'll do IMAX 2. We'll get the full effect.
Oh, my stomach. Can't take it. All right. Any other words about the plot of F9?
I did kind of like when Vin Diesel was dying and they did all the little flashbacks.
The Samson and Delilah where he just like pulls the columns down to like collapse the ceiling on himself for no reason at all.
Like, he falls down into his water.
Surrogate wife can witness it.
He falls down into the water and they just zoom in on his underwater Vin Diesel face. And then it fades into his non-underwater Vin Diesel face. And it looks almost exactly the same.
Yeah.
But I'm glad that you were touched, Bishki.
Yeah, I was a little touched.
And then at the end, they have, as they always do in these movies, they have an Echo Park cookout with some Coronas. They have a nice big bucket of Coronas.
It's the product placement, but here's what's interesting. It's a bucket of ice cold beer, glass beer Coronas that they take out in one shot. But then in the next shot, when they're drinking them, there's no sweat on the bottle. They're not like ice cold bottles. They're just like room temperature bottles with like no condensation. Do not look refreshing at all. And there's no limes in them. Like, how are you going to have a Corona without a line?
Yeah.
Like, how do you not have that?
That's their thing. You think Corona would demand that?
You thought for sure they'd have someone on set making sure. Yeah.
We don't do limes. That's what Vin Diesel would say.
The one last thing I'll say is through like 2 hours of this movie, they're saying Mr. Nobody this, Mr. Nobody that. I'm like, who the fuck is Mr. Nobody? And then finally there's a flashback where it's Kurt Russell. And I'm like, that's right. He's in these movies. I forgot.
You see Kurt Russell doing like a Zoom performance at first on this iPad.
Because that's all you see at first. And I forgot about the iPad
and he's
performance.
Like,
so they kept saying Mr. Nobody. And I was like, who the fuck is Mr. Nobody?
And he's flipping out. He's like, Mayday, Mayday. They've breached. And it looks like. If there was a Fast and the Furious ride at Universal, which there probably is, that would be playing like during the line.
While you're in line. Yes. That's exactly what it was.
That's the production value that it looked like for poor Kurt. And it was pretty funny.
Yeah. That's called a contractual option, you know?
Yeah. Oh, my God. Let's go to them Furious Bones.
No, they're F9 bones.
Let's go to them F9 bones! I can feel it in my bones. All right, Bishki, hit us with your nitrous.
He's going too soon. He's did it too soon.
Manas. Okay. Yeah, 4DX. I was worried.
Yeah.
From that thing, I was like, this was wrong, wrong choice. And after the first sequence, my tummy... But it settled down. It got used to it.
At least you didn't eat what was on the menu at this particular theater, which is nacho Doritos with cheese on them.
That just turned my stomach looking at them.
You don't need, if you're making nachos, you don't need the nacho cheese chips as the chip. Guys, this is like a sign of
idiocracy.
It's the sign of our entire society slipping.
It's slipping.
We've gone beyond the ship, fam.
It's slipping. I did do a Nathan's hot dog.
That's fine.
My popcorn was fresh and great too, by the way.
Yeah, and it was great. This Regal's nice. I'll tell you, get down to the Regal NoHo at the NoHo West Complex.
Yep.
It's pretty sweet theater. And
plenty of free parking too.
Yeah, and tons of free parking.
People were going to the movies today.
And people were at the movies.
It was affordable. It was only $11 for a matinee, 4DX ticket, which is well worth it.
There's no spacing anymore. You're sitting right next to someone. You're
right up in
there. Experiencing the 4DX. Yeah, I mean, I was kind of in and out for the first 2 hours, but that last half hour, when they get to space and it just gets...
Whoa.
Ooh, we got some furious... Fury Road.
Yeah,
going
someone just saw it and is zooming around the parking ramp.
Yeah. Anyway,
living their fast life.
By the third act or whatever act, whatever we want to call it.
Yeah, there's no acts.
Lap. They're called laps, guys.
By the third lap.
By the final lap, I just turned my brain completely off.
Yes.
I mean, it was already brain dead, but then I don't know. I was having fun. It was just so bonkers.
Yeah.
And I was just kind of smiling, giggling with the audience and kind of got the appeal of these movies. And because it was my first outing, I'm not going to do this probably again.
You don't need to.
I had a good time. 2.5 bones.
2.5?
Yeah. That's with all the bumps of everything
all
that
the bumps,
went along
with it. All the
bells
and whistles. Yeah. All right. 2.5. Brother Lucas, I'm imagining you're not going to be as kind.
You imagine very prophetically, prognosticatingly. I was really grateful to be with you both in the 4DX experience for this movie, because I think if we had seen this, 2D regular screen...
there wouldn't be as much to write home about.
Yeah, it would have been a much harder slog to sit through a two and a half hours. I'm not emotionally invested in the backstories or characters, but you kind of hit the nail on the head in that it's just, it takes itself too seriously. And yeah, it is silly and it should be sillier.
Way sillier.
And Vin Diesel needs to lighten up a little bit and show that he's human. Like, I don't know. Everyone got paid, I guess. F9, wow, it's wild. There's so many, and they're clearly leaving it open for a 10.
Of course, they have to do the 10.
Fucking 10 movies, man. Mm. They should just do crossovers, because it'd be awesome if this was F9, but with Freddy, with Robert Englund. Somehow it's Freddy F9 crossover.
Yeah, he'd have the one-liners.
Yeah, F9, the final dream lap. So I'm going to give this 2 bones. This is
2 bones.
Nice. 2 solid bones.
All right. That's love and light. This shit is long in the tooth for me at this point. I mean, the fate of the Furious was huge as well. And this one didn't push things in any new directions other than the space stuff. The magnets weren't enough to really distinguish it for me. And I don't think that this movie is going to be one of the highlights of the series when people look back on it. I think they're going to be like, oh, that was okay. That was a meat and potatoes installment. That said, a lot can be said about the 4DX experience, the fact that we were all being brutalized together in a little row. That's shared trauma that bonds people together, and I really appreciate that aspect of it. I just wish it was funnier, man, But anyway, I'm just griping because we're 9 movies into
this. And you watched them all.
And I watched them all, and I want to be rewarded. I want I want there to be a victory lap.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not just a hard working continuation lap.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's a 1 bone movie, but I'll bump it up to 1.5 because I had such a good time.
Master goes the lowest, but
it's very rare.
Yeah.
Very rare. But I gotta demand the best from my Fast franchise at this point. I'm too invested.
Just make it shorter. I feel like if you pack a wallop like a punch and just leave us with our head spinning, and it's like Mad Max Fury Road is like a high octane ride from start to finish. You've got me.
People will like it more.
But if you're gonna have these underwater near death experience flashbacks, and it's tying into other flashbacks, we've already seen these multiple flashbacks. It's like, oh man, I need more Helen Mirren in my life, and she wasn't in this enough.
She's in one scene.
Yeah.
Anyway. Well, we did it, folks.
Yeah.
And
speaking of the best, can I make a song request?
Absolutely.
Vin Diesel's Feel Like I Do.
Yes! Yes! That is the finest moment of television. Was it the Today Show or Good Morning America? One of those shows, he debuted his pop song. And because it was COVID times, the audience was all just like giant iPads, like next to each other.
Nothing dystopian about that. Nothing dystopian hellscape about that.
And the idea was they were listening to this song for the first time and they were going to be reacting to it. And his weird ass song starts up. And you just see all these people via Zoom or Skype just kind of listlessly dancing and bopping their heads to this Vin Diesel jam. Look it up on YouTube.
I didn't
see it. You haven't seen that shit?
I didn't see the reactions, though.
It's the best thing that's ever been produced.
I've just been listening to the song all year.
Yes, yeah. You will get that. And a special announcement, y'all. We're taking our first ever break.
Yeah.
It's going to be summer break for us. We've been going for 3 years every week, and we're going to live life a little bit. We're going to live life one summer day at a time.
Taking a little hiatus.
We'll describe it more in detail in a future break episode coming up next week.
Get outside.
Take your summer breaks, y'all.
Get some fresh air, some sunshine, some exercise.
And if you miss us, go back to the very beginning, to the wrinkle in time, and relive the golden oldies.
You can listen to old episodes while you do a new hobby or get reacquainted with an old hobby.
And watch some of these movies. You know, watch Gotti. Watch Speed Kills.
Yes.
Watch Cats.
Yes. Always watch Cats.
Watch Welcome to Marwen.
Yes, please. Check them off your list. You know you've been meaning to do it, but we'll be back in September, and we love you, and we're going to miss you until then. But
till then, be safe, be well, love and light.
Love and light. We'll see you guys very soon. Love and light, and Vin Diesel.
Take it away, Vin.
Just did a spit take.